Well, thank you very much, Desiree. We've been crossing live here from the University of Johannesburg, Soweto campus, and this is where the Gauteng Premier, David Makhura, will deliver his State of the Province address. Many of the dignitaries, as you can see here behind me, have already started arriving. He will deliver that address at 10 o'clock this morning. We've been chatting to quite a number of dignitaries. Joining me now is the MEC for Infrastructure. Thank you so much for joining us, Tasneem Mutara, this morning. Look, a lot of expectation from the Premier this morning in terms of infrastructure development and how you plan to redirect the budget, you know, to benefit the people of Gauteng. Talk to us a bit about that. And, you know, obviously, if we look at infrastructure development, this will talk hospitals and a number of other areas as well.
Yes, definitely. Infrastructure development as a whole constitutes quite a large number, a big component of the budget. And we need to redirect it to be able to uplift and empower SMMEs, especially women-owned contractors, construction companies, professional services, architects, and the whole range of professional services from beginning to end and in the delivery. But also, I think we'll have to be able to streamline and improve on how we deliver infrastructure to be able to deal with the influx of people into the province. The education system is under a lot of stress, the health system is under a lot of pressure, and infrastructure forms part of a big component of how we are able to bear that pressure.
How are you able to do that? How are you hoping to do that as the sixth legislature, in that with the influx of people that we're seeing in Gauteng, that putting a lot of pressure, as you already alluded to, how then do you plan to do things slightly differently this time to ensure that some of the challenges in education, in health and other sectors as well are alleviated?
Well, so some of our processes need to be shortened. So for instance, we'll be looking at how we better use the PPPFMA to be able to shorten processes so that things such as maintenance, key maintenance, breakdowns, to be able to address those very, very quickly. Those, of course, that are legislated for through the PFMA, will adhere to them, but we'll use our legislative authority and power to be able to shorten some of the processes that are really a hindrance to delivering as quick as we want to.
Some of those infrastructure development challenges, talk to us a bit about that. You've already alluded quite briefly to it, and how this time in the sixth legislature you'd want to speed up the delivery of some of these issues that you speak about to ensure that not just the health system or the education system, things are approved in terms of service delivery.
Well, we've got a very good working model with the Department of Education, so we were able to deliver a school a month. We'll still be able to do that, so we want to take what we've learned from working with the Department of Education to be able to also copy that with departments such as health, knowing that, of course, the infrastructure is different, but we should be able to shorten the time in terms of delivery. So education we've been able to improve. I think for us, which the area of focus is the maintenance. So it can't take us 3 months to be able to replace a part just because we are following due process. We've got to be able to shorten it, working within the ambit of the law. And if it means legislative changes, we'll do that.
All right. Thank you very much for your time. It's freezing here in Soweto this morning, so we're going to let you go. Thank you very much for your time. The MEC of Infrastructure here in Gauteng, Tasneem Mutara, on some of the priorities that she's expecting this sixth legislature to deal with in terms of some of the key areas, including health and education. Some of those components we're expecting the Gauteng Premier, David Makhura, to address quite extensively, also with regard to the creation of jobs in this particular province. Back to you in studio for now.
Thanks, Criselda, and we'll continue to monitor that story for you, especially when the State of the Province goes on live.